These statements are all true and factual, to the best of my knowledge.
Danny.
Late.
You know what I just saw?
No, but I'm genuinely late.
The Burn Burton Performing Arts Department will present a critically acclaimed drama originally produced more than 30 years ago, A Few Good Men. Opening night is Wednesday, November 8th, and the play will have a four-day run before closing on Saturday, November 11th. Many will remember the movie, which came out in 1992 and starred Tom Cruise, Jack Nicholson, Demi Moore, and Kevin Bacon, among others. Written by Aaron Sorkin, originally as a play, it poses a question. Should members of the military, and maybe anyone, make obeying orders the one and only imperative, or should obeying one's personal conscience be the guiding light? The plot unfolds over the course of a court-martial of two Marines who perform a code red, or extreme physical punishment, on a fellow Marine for some sort of breaking of the informal rules. The cover-up of what really happened also entangles two attorneys over who should handle the case. But enough of the spoiler alerts. We talked to Jim Raposa of the school's performing arts department, who directed the play, to learn more.
Well, you know, we had made a conscious effort since the pandemic to, you know, pick shows that were light and fun and fluffy, and we did that on purpose. But these young actors were really stating that they wanted to have the challenge of doing a drama. And there's nothing better than Aaron Sorkin. There's nothing better than A Few Good Men. And it was also a challenge for us to do that with gender blind casting, which we did. We put the best person got the role. That was not based on gender. That was based on who was the best actor. And that has offered some very interesting opportunities for the actors to delve into these characters and to say these words that are so well written. It is about two young Marines who perform a code red on another Marine, and the juxtaposition is that these Marines endangered this other Marine, and their statement was, we were just following orders. So then the question is, if they were just following orders, can they be held accountable? And then this show dives into that, and whose orders were they following, and should they be found guilty, and should they serve whatever they're going to serve from the sentence? And so it's a real peeling away of what it is to be a young soldier or a young person in the military and follow orders. There are moral orders, and then there are orders, and what is that choice? Again, you know, this show came to fame because, of course, Jack Nicholson, Demi Moore, Tom Cruise, and so it's indelible in our consciousness here, but it's always interesting when people find out that the play was an original play. It was originally a play. Then it was brought out in Los Angeles, and Rob Reiner directed it. And then what Aaron Sorkin did was he took some of the changes from the movie and placed them back into the script.
We also got a chance to talk with two of the actors, Sadie Eggers and Julian Peary, about their roles and the challenges of doing the play.
So I play the role of Jack Ross, or Jackie Ross, in this show. It's originally done by Kevin Bacon in the movies. He is basically the lawyer of the government. So Kathy and Sam and Joe are the defense, and I'm like the prosecutor who is like basically like charging the two Marines. So that's the character I play. I think especially for my character, it's been interesting to kind of play this. My character especially has been kind of on the fence in between the two. Like, we had talked about, Jimmy and I, we had talked about how my character has like gone through more of the actual Marine experience than maybe Kathy has, who just went directly to becoming a lawyer. And I'm also really good friends with Kathy, so it's like I kind of have this split kind of loyalties, like where I don't want Kathy to get in trouble for saying the wrong thing, especially since he doesn't have as much experience in court. And I also want to protect all the men and kind of the code, because really what's being put on trial in general is just the code that the Marines stand by and what they're kind of, the way that they run things, which is kind of a difficult thing to question and not too difficult. But I think in general, most, you know, it's totally different than any of the other shows that I've done here. A lot of them have been comedic or like maybe a couple dramatic, but in general, they are like, they're still kind of more straightforward dramatic pieces. This one is so interesting because there's so much to get wrong, especially with the Marines. You know, you don't want to disrespect people regardless of what anyone might think about, you know, military in general. It's so important to us that we kind of get the movement and the presence and everything about like the reason why being a Marine matters to whoever is one. Getting all of that right has been super important for all of us. We had two people who are in the Marines come in actually a week ago, and we got to really talk to them, and we worked on like a lot of movement stuff, and we kind of got a really unique experience to talk to them about, you know, why did they want to be Marines, what is important to them, what do they think being a Marine means. And I think that's been really interesting and really actually complex to kind of find this almost like machine-like movement that everyone has in the show. And it's so different for everyone, you know. You have so much like different kind of like, you have the hierarchy of like who has more power, who's, you know, and especially with Kathy's character, he challenges that so often. And I get to kind of be the person who like looks at him as like, you're not supposed to do that. And then he does it anyways. And so I sit in the corner worrying the whole time, but it's been really interesting, and it's been a really unique experience to kind of, it's a completely different character. It's not just you're playing a character and moving however you might move, but just acting. It's like you have to fully like embody this role, because Marines have such a different kind of just posture and just presence in a room.
I play Daniel Caffey, the part that was played by Tom Cruise in the original movie. So the main part, I would say. Well, this is the hardest play I've ever done, 100%. Simply because I'm really good at comedy and like physical comedy. So a play that goes wrong was super easy for me to do, especially because it involved a lot of physical comedy and comedy between your castmates. But this one, being a drama, is a lot more emotionally intensive for me and a lot more, I wouldn't say taxing, but tiring. Like whenever we have like long rehearsal days, it's really hard for me to sort of dig deep into the character that needs to be like, that needs to emerge when I'm playing it, and to do that for a long time. And it's just, yeah, it's super difficult because this character has a lot of underlying, I don't want to say trauma, but underlying disappointment with himself, because his dad passed away when he was very young, and he didn't feel like he got to prove himself to his father. And so it's a lot of what isn't seen by the audience, which is like underneath your whole character of what you're showing to the audience, which is pretty tiring, because to make it seem believable, you need to believe it yourself. At least that's the way I do it. Yeah, we had two Marines come in, I want to say about a week and a half ago, and they came in and told us what it was like being in the Marines and like what their choices were for being in the Marines. And they described it as it has changed a lot since back in the, I want to say old days, but like back in the 80s and 70s. And it's changed a lot from sort of doing what you're told and like being it much more individualized to being a much more community sort of, I don't know how to phrase it, but being much more of a community. And how when you're in the Marines now, it's much more of you're in a family. And I'm not sure if Code Red still go on now. I mean, I'm sure there's hazing and all that sort of stuff, but I don't know if it's to the degree which it was back then. Yeah, well, definitely it's a load of fun, but also it's, again, difficult, but that's the fun of it. You sort of get to challenge yourself and sort of try to prove yourself to yourself.
Tickets are on sale now, and you can find them by going to ticketor.com/ BBA tickets. Opening night is Wednesday, November 8th, and the curtain rises at 6:30 p.m. The last performance will be held Saturday, November 11th, and all the shows start at 6:30 p.m. For the GNAT-TV News Project, I'm Andrew McKeever.